The common housefly, as its name implies, plagues the households of mankind around the world. It cannot bite or sting, but its physical structure and feeding habits make it a carrier of disease and death. It spreads the organisms that cause typhoid fever, dysentery, tuberculosis, leprosy, hookworm, cholera, diarrhea, anthrax, gangrene, and numerous other painful diseases and parasites that inflict suffering and death upon mankind. If the housefly were not such a restless explorer of everything in sight, it would not be such a dangerous pest. But it is equally at home as it visits back and forth between surroundings of finery and places of filth. Let's consider some of the important structural features of the housefly. It is a true insect. It belongs to the order of insects named Diptera, which means two wings. Its two transparent wings fold back to give it a triangular appearance when not flying. Bristle-like hairs cover parts of the fly's body. These hairs are one of the means by which the fly picks up and transports millions of disease germs as it visits sources of contamination. Being a true insect, the housefly has three distinct body parts: a head, a thorax, and an abdomen. The head bears the eyes, antennae, and mouth parts or proboscis. The surface of each of the large compound eyes is divided into approximately 4,000 facets or individual lenses. The eyes of the male housefly are spaced closer together than those of the female. Between its compound eyes, the housefly also has three ocelli or simple eyes. But in spite of this elaborate equipment for seeing, the housefly depends mainly on its highly sensitive antennae in detecting odors which are attractive to it.
Jurisdiction empowered and entrusted by every major national government with the task of containing anomalous objects, entities, and phenomena. These anomalies pose a significant threat to global security by threatening either physical or psychological harm.
If you go into noise music with an open mind and know that it's not going to be like a conventional form of music, and you're not going to get the same experience as you would with a conventional form of music, I think that's a great way to start.
As I lie here, I think of what once was. As I lie here, I think of her. As I lie here, I think of my loved ones and how they miss me. As I lie here, I think of pretension. As I lie here,
is there anything you'd particularly like to do?
I've always seen these movies with people going to Africa and becoming missionaries and all. Well, and I'd like to go to an area and civilize some people. If there are any people left to civilize, I just could wear my khaki shorts and one of those hats and go down there.
Yes, cities, nations, even civilization itself, threatened with annihilation, because in one moment of history-making violence, nature, mad, rampant, wrought its most awesome creation. For born in that swirling inferno of radioactive dust were things so horrible, so terrifying, so hideous, there is no word to describe them.
Locomotive is one of man's most valuable tools. He uses it to move heavy freight trains and fast passenger trains. In reality, this locomotive is a powerful steam engine mounted on wheels.
We'll be right back. time of acquisition, SCP-407 was recorded within a compact cassette tape. Currently, SCP-407 is backed up as a digital audio file on... SCP-407 should not be allowed to play under any circumstances outside testing conditions.
Oh! I really don't like flying, but if you don't fly, you don't get anywhere, so you just have to keep calm.
Get out and get it done.
Yeah. I could never, if I didn't fly, I just couldn't be in as many places as I can be now.